Namaste. Hosting this presentation, I am Dr. Rutvik Thengolkar. I would like to present our activities and outcomes of our ongoing work during the COVID-19 lockdown. Since CRC, Sinopharm Research Center, was developed with the help of individual donations, we are reaching out to all Indians to keep them informed. CRC is a socio-scientific, non-profit, interventional research endeavor initiated to mitigate long-standing malnutrition in India. We all have witnessed how low immunity increases mortality during this pandemic. This gave us inspiration to work on COVID-19 solutions likewise. During the first lockdown, our interns got locked themselves in the lab and worked full-time voraciously. We were considering identification of natural resource hygienics that generate alternative income for tribals, as malnourishment is closely linked with general immunity. At the same time, Dr. Li Wenliang from the Wuhan Central Hospital blew the whistle to medical fraternity regarding the deadly corona outbreak. Considering the situation, we expedited our work and voyaged into this additional responsibility of research in hygienics. The preparations developed from MAPS, endowed with antimicrobial properties, was assessed microbiologically for its efficacy analysis by this diffusion method as depicted above. Sharvari has completed her thesis work for award in Masters in Bioinformatics from University of Mumbai. The research involved in her work directly impacts farmers involved in aquaculture and is a subgroup objective of the lab to curb malnutrition. A part of her work was awarded third prize by the prestigious Center of Advanced Studies, University of Madras. Continuing his work on malnourishment, Ashray performed biochemical assessments of various macronutrients, namely proteins, carbohydrates, etc., and micronutrient analysis like iron, zinc, calcium, etc., that are being studied in Indian traditional ingredients in the lab-made fortified food. Sunanda was complementing Ashray's work by identifying macro and micronutrient compositions from his fortified food and forest fields, fruits and vegetables. This project, known as Swayam Siddha Poshan Yojana, was presented and well received by the Ministry of Tribal Affairs. While the project is under consideration at MOTA, Sinopharm Research Center decided to march forward to evaluate the nutritional value of the local tubers found in tribal areas. In line with eradicating malnourishment, Ashray and Sunanda performed qualitative and quantitative biochemical assessments of various protein mixtures vis-a-vis the lab-made fortified food during the first lockdown. During lockdown, intern Vaishnavi was completing her thesis work for Bachelor's of Engineering, Information Technology by SNDT University, Mumbai. The research is development of a model system which stores data into a microcontroller using multiple environmental sensors in real time and delivers a graphical representation for immediate intervention. Though our laboratory is not geared for virology work and SARS-CoV-2 is relatively novel, we succeeded in getting the Government of India Science and Engineering Research Board accept our proposal for evaluation to assess bioactive metabolites in algae to combat COVID-19. CRC team has spent many sleepless nights to achieve this deadline in short time. Lockdown has given the required time to intern Kautuk Marolia, second year art student, to complete writing his book on insects. His entomology passion was nurtured and has led to collection and recording of more than 150 specimens in the semi-deciduous forest of Kesavasrushti. This will lead to an asset development apart from actually documenting of ecological status in UVSS in the book titled Buzzing and Blooming. Vaishnavi presented her research of model system which stores data into a microcontroller using multiple environmental sensors in real time, delivering a graphical representation for immediate intervention at the International Conference on Advanced Trends in Engineering. She got another feather in the cap of CRC Kesavasrushti amidst this pandemic. Sinopharm's junior team during Unlockdown 1.0 participated in National World Environmental Day, competition organized by the Council of Scientific Industrial Research, CSIR, and VIBA. These Baal Vaigyaniks, as we call them, are working on fruit fly, Drosophila melanogaster, mosquitoes in their vicinity, initiating epidemiological studies and environmental effect on plant growth. During the third lockdown, Kautuk Marolia submitted a video about his observations on Kesar Srishti environment during the lockdown period, while Ms. Sharvari Sawant submitted a write-up about her experience of the lockdown period in South Mumbai. Ashray Bhavsar penned down his experience in Mumbai's suburban region. CSR's junior team working on Drosophila melanogaster, light effect on plant growth and initiating epidemiological studies in the vicinity participated in yet another national level competition conducted by Government of India, CSIR, NISCAIR on the occasion of World Environmental Day 2020. Dr. Prabhu raised a concern with the Government of India, indicating that research or diagnosis on COVID is jeopardized due to current rules deployed by ICMR. These concerns were addressed by the government in due course of time that came up in the Indian Express, which allowed more researchers contribute to the war against COVID. Sinopharm co-PI and clinical research head Dr. Prabhu received permission and NABL accreditation for testing SARS-CoV-2. He is also a medical research scientist at Sinopharm Research Center since inception and is testing more than 600 COVID samples per day. Currently, Sinopharm team is focused on writing a review script on COVID-19. The manuscript addresses solutions for COVID-19 pathogenesis of SARS-CoV-2. For our research paper on COVID-19, we have been communicating with various world experts like Dr. Xu Ziyonghua from the University of Chicago Medicine, Dr. Wessler from University of Washington, and Dr. Guzik, the University of Glasgow. Let me unequivocally state here that the work introduced here is a community endeavor of individuals showing up above. Some of them like Ashray, Sunanda, Dipali and Sharvari had sleepless nights. I thank every one of them for their sincerity, commitment and dedication without any desires consequently. The Baal Vaigyanik group draws out enthusiasm in the lab while delivering difficulties for our understanding when they pose exceptionally straightforward inquiries, those that don't have straight answers. Thank you and thanks for watching patiently.